Hey guys, thanks for jumping back into the Cryptoverse. Today we're going to go over Bitcoin. If you guys like this content, please subscribe to the channel and like the video and turn your notifications on. I read most of the comments, as I'm sure you guys are aware that I respond to many of them, so if you have any feedback, let me know. Today we're going to go over Bitcoin, and we're essentially going to cover what we covered yesterday with Ethereum. We're just going to look at the average buy-in price on different time frames, and what you might expected or what the average ROI would have been on those time for some of those time frames. So first we're going to look at just day of the week. Historically, if we were to conglomerate every day since the inception of Bitcoin, or at least since say 2010, where I have price data, what would have been the best time to buy Bitcoin? So the average buy-in price to date would be somewhere between 2120 and 2140. And you would have been, depending on what day of the week you buy, your buy-in price would have been, it could have been up to $20 difference. So Tuesdays, would have been the worst days to buy. Fridays would have been the best days to buy. I should point out this is not statistically significant in any way. The standard deviations on these are astronomical because the price changes, the price swings are just so large. So you have to consider that. But just if you have been buying, every Tuesday since the beginning of Bitcoin, you actually would have been paying a little bit of a premium on it had you been buying on every Friday. So it's just something to put in your back pocket. It's not necessarily meant to inform your dec or to make your decision. It's just meant for you to help inform your decisions on when you want to, buy Bitcoin. If we move on to a different time frame, so if we look at the monthly time frame, you can see that there's pretty interesting trend here. So in February, March, and April, you have actually been getting the best price on average. You'd have been paying around $1,700, as opposed to say July or August when you would have been paying on average $2,400. Now I think so 17 divided by 24. So I think that's about 70%. I could be off. So you basically in February, March, or April, you'd be paying around 70% of what you would have been paying had you bought in, say, the summer. And I mean, you could probably find years where that's not the case, but this is just on average. And the interesting thing is, we saw this year. If you had been buying Bitcoin in February, March, or April, you would have been getting a price of maybe 3 to 4 grand. If you had been buying in May or June, you'd been paying a few thousand dollars more. I mean, people were buying at say $13,000, $14,000 in the summer, which on average is a bad buying price, or a bad time to be buying if you just look at the history of Bitcoin. So I think that's interesting, that typically buying in the summer is not necessarily the best time to buy Bitcoin, on average, in terms of getting the most Bitcoin for your dollar. So you can see, more or less, in January it's around a little, it's like 2150. It drops down all the way to 1700 for these 3 months, goes all the way up to around 2400, and then oscillates between 22 and 2400 more or less. So I think it's just an interesting thing to point out, in terms of when you time your buys with Bitcoin. If we move forward in time and look at quarters, I mean, there's a fairly clear trend. If you're looking to buy Bitcoin, quarter one on average is much better than any other quarter. Your average buy-in is around 1850 versus 2350 had you bought in quarter three. And note that between quarter three and quarter four, there's not a huge difference on your average buy-in, but quarter one and quarter two have historically been much better, quarter one being the best time to buy Bitcoin, in terms of getting the most Bitcoin for your dollar. Now, if we look at the year time frame, I mean, the trend is obvious. I mean, buy Bitcoin, just looking at historical data, you would have been doing the best had you just bought Bitcoin earlier. So if you don't want to worry about what day of the week, what month of the year, what quarter maybe, just look at the years. Historically, you'd be doing much better on your average buy-in price if you just buy it now, if you just bought it each progressive year, you would have just had a better average buy-in price. There's only 1 or 2 years where that would not have been the case. So in 2014, you would have had a higher buy-in price than 2015, and 2018 you would have had a higher buy-in price than 2019. Now, most assets, are not going to monotonically increase as a function of time, which means they're not just always just going to go straight up without any type of corrections. They're gonna see those corrections. So this is just, this is just par for the course in a sense. I mean, Bitcoin is highly speculative. I don't really think it's gotten to its true fair valuation that it is anticipated to get to. Yeah, I mean, obviously at some point you would think it needs to level off. I don't think we're there yet. Just based off the other analysis and the videos that I've shown. But you can see that more or less, just the earlier you buy Bitcoin, the better off you would have been. I mean, in 2010, your average buy-in would have been 10 cents. In 2011, it would have been around $5. 2012, it would have been around $9. 2013, around $200. 2014, around $400 or $500. 2015 would have been around maybe $300. 2016, again, around maybe $500 or $600. 2017 would have been around $4,000. 2018 would have been around, say, $7,000, and we're also at currently around $7,000 in 2019. So if we continue this trend, I mean, some of you might be, so worried that Bitcoin is going to drop a few K. Not to say it won't, but in the grand scheme of things, if you think this trend is going to continue, which is somewhat dubious to think, but if you do think it's going to continue, then the average buy-in price is only going to go up. And I mean, you can see how far we've come so far, all the way from an average buy-in of maybe like say 18 cents versus an average buy-in of $7,000. I mean, an average buy-in of $7,000 might seem quite reasonable if the average buy-in in 3 years is say $50,000. So just keep these macro level pictures in mind in this market. Now, if we were to look at the average 90-day ROI, so let's say you wanted to buy Bitcoin and you had to sell it 3 months later because of whatever. You just had to sell it. You had to liquidate your position. Historically, what would have been the best month to buy if you had to sell it 90 days later? Well, in June and July, on average, you would have seen an ROI of around one. So more or less in the history of Bitcoin, if you had bought it in June or July and sold it 90 days later, your average return would have been breaking even. And these error bars here are not the standard deviation. They're the standard deviation divided by the square root of the entire data set. Otherwise, the standard deviations would be, the actual standard deviation is quite large. But this just helps show you kind of the volatility. It's called the standard error, I believe. So just it's dividing by the square root of the total number of data points. So one of the things we note is buying in March and then selling in June has historically been the best time to see a 90-day return on your investment. So if you had bought in March of any given year, on average, you would have seen around a 3.7x in your investment 90 days later. Now, there are some years where that might have been more. There's some years where it might have been less. Maybe there are some years where you would have been at a loss. But on average, you would have seen about a 3.5, 3.7x return on your investment. And then, in January, it would have been about a 2x ROI if you had bought in January, sold in April. In September, it also would have been a 2x. In November, around a 1.5x. So this is just on average over the last 9 or 10 years. But I do think it's interesting that, March and April have historically been the best times to buy. And even this year, this was the case as well. I mean, think about it. In March and April this year, Bitcoin was at around, between 3 and 4 grand. And then if you had sold it in the summer, you would have seen about a three or about a 3 to 4x return. I mean, you could have bought it at say three and like $3,500, and then sold it for 14 grand. So that's exactly a 4x on your investment. Had you done that? So just something else I think is quite interesting. And then if we continue going, this just okay. So I think this chart here is just something else I did with the error bar. So I'm just gonna move on to the next one. So this one is an average 1 year return on investment. So if you bought Bitcoin and you had to sell it 1 year later, no matter what, on average, you would have been doing the best if you're buying in September and selling a year later, and you would have been doing the worst if you were buying in July and selling a year later. So in July, on average, since Bitcoin, since we have the price history, you would have seen about a 3x on your investment on average. Whereas in September, if you bought in September and then sold the following September, your ROI on average would have been around 13x. That's pretty decent return. Let me know what you guys think of this video. I made one for Ethereum yesterday, made one for Bitcoin today. Just like to hear what you guys think as I do these different types of analyses and, get feedback on them. Remember to subscribe to the channel if you guys like this content. Comment down below, and I will try to go through those comments, let you know what I think. And also, if you have any ideas that you want to communicate to me quickly, you can always join my Telegram channel, or you can follow me on Twitter. I'm pretty typically more responsive on Telegram. So if there's some huge idea that you have that you want me to look at, and I think it's worthwhile to look at it, maybe you just don't have the time to look at it, or maybe you don't know how to do it. Let me know, and maybe I can link into it. All right, guys, that's it for this video. Until next time, bye.